Ryan, I think you've been in the streams a couple times with some of the other people that was in here. But what we do here is play a game called Spec Collect Forget. And let me ask you this. Are you familiar with the game F, Marry, Kill?
Yes, yes.
Well, in case you're in the audience right now and you've never played this game or whatever, F, Marry, Kill is typically a game you would play with your friends where you would say, you would name three people, right? Yeah, maybe you'd name three celebrities, Beyonce, Rihanna, Lady Gaga. And you would say, which one of these would you F or bang? Which one of these would you marry? And which one of these would you kill? If you had to choose one of them, and then, you know, that's the game, and you play with your friends or whatever. So in this video here, I got this game called Spec Collect Forget. We're going to do the comic book version, which I'm going to show three books. And then, Ryan, you got to say which one you would want to spec, collect, or forget. Spec in this instance meaning, no, you're gonna speculate on that. It's not gonna be on your top 50 list, right? It's gonna be in the bin. You're gonna hold it. You're gonna wait for that book to get hot, and then you're gonna flip it, and you're gonna make some money on that. You're gonna have that one night stand with this book. Collect, you're gonna put the ring on it. You're marrying it. It's gonna go on that shelf behind your head for everybody to see in your YouTube videos. And kill, you're gonna burn it. You're gonna be like the guy who is handling your ASM 50. You're just gonna, you know, toss it across the room, rip the corner, set it ablaze, hand it off to Mephisto, never to be seen again.
I'm nervous about all the twos I'm going to see in this.
It's a good thing that you remind that, because this is the most important part here. We need people in the audience here. You know, we got about like 50 people here in the chat, so we got to get you guys audience participation. We're going to need your suggestions, or we're going to need your guys' thoughts on Ryan's picks here, because he's going to give his picks. He's going to say which ones he's going to spec, collect, forget. And then when we go over to the audience, you guys need to say, put a one in the chat if you agree with Ryan's picks. Put a two in the chat if you disagree. Now, there are no wrong answers. There's no prizes here. It's just a fun game. And here's the thing. You know, Ryan, you don't have to be logical about this. This is your own personal opinion. This is your books that you like. And if you want to pick Silver Surfer books all day, you can pick Silver Surfer books all day. No judgment. I mean, no judgment for me. There might be tons of judgment in the chat, but you know, it's your game to play. So does everyone kind of get it? Everyone kind of get the rules? Makes sense to everybody down there? So one's in the chat, guys. Let me know what you guys think. Two's in the chat if you don't like it. All right.
If I'm anything, I'm opinionated on my choices. So I'm not going to cave to the chat.
That's good. Good that you have to have conviction, and you got to give context into your picks here. All right. Well, the first one I have here is coming off the heels of me having gone to TorpedoCon. There was a lot of artists and writers there, and there were ones doing some signings. Namely, one of them was actually Jim Lee. Now, I didn't get a Jim Lee signing, but I did think to myself, if I was going to get a Jim Lee book signed, which one of these would I get signed? And that's where I throw it over to you in Spec, Collect, Forget. We got some Jim Lee covers here. A lot of them coming out of the Copper Age, and classic covers all around. We have Wolverine number 27. We got Uncanny X-Men number 268, and we got X-Men number 11. All beautiful covers featuring Wolverine, drawn by Jim Lee. Spec, collect, forget. What are your thoughts?
All right. So I was a big Wolverine fan in that run of Wolverine when I was a kid as well. And so I have a lot of those books. And so the one that really jumps out to me, and it's on the video game. So that's what makes that book, cool. So,
yeah.
So for me, definitely my collect is Wolverine 27.
Okay. Putting the ring on it right there.
Then X-Men number 11, it's one of the most, it's one of the most well-known and traded Wolverine covers. It is a really well-known cover. I think there's like a weird variant that has like a gray background. It's like one of these, that one, it's like $1,000 for a 9.8 or something. Send in some like mailer or something. And so like, I know that that's one that I would spec on, because that's one that I don't really have a lot of attachment to it, but if price goes up, I'd flip it. And I'm gonna forget X-Men 268.
Burning X-Men, no love for Captain America or Black Widow there on the cover. All right, guys, you know what to do. Votes are in. One's in the chat if you agree with Ryan here. Two's in the chat if you disagree. You know, I feel like, you know, I was thinking I was maybe going to get a Jim Lee signing or whatever. And I was like, oh, what books do I have? I actually do have all three of these books, but I just wasn't sure which one I myself.
I'm not sure if I have X-Men 11. I might have that one in a box somewhere. I know I have 27. Like, I know I have that.
All right. The votes are coming in here. See, King Lucci with the one, Ian with the one, Lee Tell with the one here, Mark with the one, Comic Book Bonus with the one, Empire with the emphatic quadruple one. Trilogy, what's going on, man, with the one here. Carnival Hands, good to see you with the two. St. Louis with the one. Nowhere Bound with the one. Look at that. Everybody is feeling you on this one here, Ryan. All right. Everyone, we're off to a really, really great start. A lot of ones here. And again, I am often reminded that if I were to play my own game, I think I would be getting twos all day.
Was X-Men 268 going to be your collector?
You know, I have to think about it, but I really do love X-Men 268. So I don't know. I don't know what I would have done if I were in your shoes, in the actual hot seat, what I would have picked. But we got to go on to the next one here. We're seeing what this is because, you know, I actually don't even remember because I got the curtains on. Oh, I do remember. We actually talked about this just a second ago. We got some story comic books here. We got some storyline comic books. Spec Collect Forget. We got Infinity Gauntlet number one. All right. We already heard that, you know, that was one of your favorite stories growing up. We got Secret Wars number one. A lot of people thinking we might be going to the Secret Wars thing soon. We got X-Men 137. People love these X-Men comic books. This is the Death of Phoenix, the culmination of the Dark Phoenix storyline. Spec Collect Forget. What are you feeling here?
So this one is surprisingly maybe pretty easy for me. So, I mean, we just talked about the Infinity Gauntlet. So,
yeah.
I mean, that's definitely like I have a copy of that book sitting in the other room, like right next to me, that I picked up recently. So, because I bought the full run. And so that is definitely my collect.
Okay. Putting the ring on Infinity Gauntlet. I mean, hey, I can't personally argue with that one.
Then I'm going to forget X-Men 137. And it's not that I don't like those books. I mean, I'll tell you, I really do like the Bronze Age X-Men books. It's a tough call. It's a tough call for these two.
X-Men guys. He hates
So, because I mean, honestly, maybe I'm trying to get people to not buy them because I've been buying up like Bronze Age X-Men and that kind of stuff. But I don't think we're going to see a Phoenix storyline for a while. And X-Men 101, honestly, is probably it's in my top three probably covers of all time for me. I love that cover. And so I really like the Phoenix storyline. I wish somebody would do it a little better, but unfortunately they've done it twice already. And so I just don't see Marvel wanting to repeat that for a while. I think they probably will, but it might not be for like 15 years. Right. And so that's why I'm forgetting that one. And then I am specking on Secret Wars because we're getting Secret Wars. getting that.
It feels like we are going to get them for sure. So let me know, guys in the chat, everybody, guys and gals, put a one there for me if you think that Ryan got it right. Put a two if you think he got it wrong. Also, as we're going through, kind of like what Empire was saying here, I want to hear your guys' picks as well. So if you have thoughts, like, you know, send them in because I'm curious to hear what you would say. But Empire here, you know, was doing the same thing you did. Collect Infinity War or Infinity Gauntlet, spec on Secret Wars, and forget X-Men. But let's see what the people thought here. Trilogy, right off the bat with a one. Chat went crazy. One, even though it hurts to forget two X-Men books in a row, with Comics with Bonix, one with Mark here, Empire with the one, Ian with the one, Spiders Comics going at Man with the one, St. Louis Ron with the one. Okay, a lot of ones. Everyone is in an agreement. This is like a very, you know, collaborative chat. Everyone is feeling this. Ryan, thanks for
being on the show. But I agree with Comics with Bonix. Like, I mean, it's, I'm high on X-Men books. Like, I think those are great books to buy. Like, you know, something's coming eventually, but I just, that specific one, I've got to toss it to the side.
I mean, you know, look, this is the thing. It's like one of these books has to go. That doesn't mean that it's a bad book. It's just, you can only choose one. All right, going on to the next batch here, we got Spec Collect Forget. We got some Bronze Age love here. We got some Bronze Age villain first appearances. Spec Collect Forget. We got ASM 194, first appearance of Black Cat. We got Daredevil 131, first appearance of Bullseye. And we got Miss Marvel 18, first appearance of Mystique. Spec Collect Forget. How are you feeling with this one? Everybody in the chat, let me know what you guys think as well.
So yeah, I mean, I love all of these books. I prefer Mystique's cameo book, but still, I think that is a good one. But for me, I'm always a little hesitant on villains. So when I'm talking about something that you're trying to keep long-term, that kind of thing, like villains are always tough. They don't tend to do as well as heroes. So I will kind of look at Black Cat is a villain, but she's kind of she doesn't always play a villain. She plays on the hero side as well. So for Collect, I'm going to go with 194. That it's a great cover. I'm not gonna say it's one of my favorite covers or anything, but it is a great cover. It's a great character, and it's a super popular just character in general. Artists love drawing her, and so she's always going to be kind of in the medium that people are seeing out in front. Yeah, now,
well said.
For Forget, I am going to have to go with Mystique, and so that's Ms. Marvel 18, because it's a character that was played so well that I think they might have a hard time replacing her for a while, and they might want to go another way. I think it's a similar challenge they're going to have with Wolverine. I mean, Hugh Jackman, like he was Wolverine. He was perfect for that role. And so, but I think that they're probably not going to want to touch. She was such a central character to so much of that X-Men universe, the Fox universe, that I don't see them really bringing her back necessarily right away. So then the spec is going to be Daredevil 131. And because that one's, he's really like the most villainous of all of them. And so that's a book that I'm going to sell when I get the chance. And I kind of follow through with the things I say, and I just sold a copy of that book about a week ago. And so, so that is a book that I'm going to sell when I see prices move up on it.
Well, you were a man with conviction on this one. You knew what you wanted to do. You were playing the bull, part of the bullseye. You were a cold, hard killer, and you were no look at your shot, no look at explosions, a little something like this to Ms. Marvel 18.
So I'm wondering, did you make one for each of those, or did you think you're like, he's not going to pick that one?
I made one for each of them, but I also thought that I'm like, he's probably going to say Ms. Marvel 18. So let me not screw this up and click the wrong one.
There's a lot of people that disagree with me in that chat.
Yeah, we got to check in with the people here. We got to check in with the people. Cause let's see, we got Carnival Hands here with the one, King Lucci with the two, Spiders with the one, Mark with the one, Comics with the two, Mr. Nobody, what's going on? Good to see you with a one. One here with Nowhere, one Trilogy, one, two, two. Oh, Vancouver with the two, Brian with the two, St. Louis with the two, Carnival again with the one. We saw that. So I don't know. It was probably like a 60-40 kind of
I'd be interested to know what people would like, what their choices would be, because yeah, I mean, I'm curious what the other way would.
Yeah. I mean, it feels like I tend to think that usually when people give twos, it's coming from a place of the book that you burned.
I think so too.
Not quite like, oh, they you know, who cares which one you married, respect, or whatever. It's the one that you burned. So maybe people really high on Mystique. I think I saw some burns of Daredevil when people were throwing out their chat there. So I don't know. Not a lot of Bullseye fans are there, I guess.
I love that Daredevil 131 cover though. I think I'm a big fan of the yellow covers. I think that they always look really good, you know, especially when they have red lettering on them. And so I do like that cover. It is a cool cover.
I do like it too. I do like it too. But hey, I'm not voting. All right. Next round here, we got Spec, Collect, Forget. We're pulling out the curtain and we got some 80s nostalgia comic books here. We've got some kind of like 80s nostalgia, some non-Marvel stuff. You always got to kind of mix it up a little bit. We got G.I. Joe number one. We got DC Presents Superman and the Masters of Universe number 47. And we got G.I. Joe number 21. Of course, G.I. Joe number one. First appearance of G.I. Joe, a lot of the characters within that ensemble team. DC Presents 47, He-Man book, very, very hot with the animated show that we just got, although the fans did not really love it, I think. I don't know, mixed reviews. And G.I. Joe 21, we got Snake Eyes here. Snake Eyes, movie just out. Spec, collect, forget. How are you feeling on this one here?
Yeah, so I know Vancouver's, he is a big G.I. Joe fan. So
well, baby, you better get this right.
Yeah, so for me, the forget is very easy on this one, and that is DC Comics Presents 47. And it's because of the reception that cartoon got. It was because that book was up so high. You know, I mean, like a 9.8 was like 3,500, 3,800. And, you know, so people were expecting great things. And then I think they just, a lot of people didn't like the show. They didn't like the angle that it went, or I think it just surprised people. So it caught them off guard from what they were expecting.
Yeah.
Now the collect, I'm going to go with G.I. Joe number one. Because I think that's the one that has the longer term general positive, you know, strength behind it with all that's being put into this G.I. Joe universe. Mm-hmm. And then the spec is going to be G.I. Joe 21, even though it's a little late, you know, the movie's already out. And so if this was like a week ago, you know, I definitely would have picked that for spec. So it's a little late. I mean, I know the reviews haven't been super great, but that is a book that I don't think is ever a bad buy. Like it is an awesome cover. It is a cool concept, you know, the no words in there and everything. And so, I think the G.I. Joe 21 is still it's a good book to pick up, but I would let it go if the prices got higher.
Gotcha. All right. So we're marrying G.I. Joe number one. We are burning DC Presents 47 and we are specking on G.I. Joe 21. You guys know what to do. Let us know in the chat here. Ones if you agree, twos if you disagree. I'm very interested to see how Vancouver Comic Junkie felt about your picks here. I'm sure he's surprised
that I burned He-Man. So
let's check it in here. So St. Louis with the one here, Ian with the one. Yeah, Comics with Bonds with the two. You know, he likes his He-Man. Basement Brother Collectibles, good to see a man with lots of ones here. No, with the one. Two flip, one and 21. Basement with the one here, Trilogy with the one, Mark with the one, Miguel with the one. So, you know, I feel like mostly ones overall. I mean, not too many. I think I saw a couple twos in there. But, you know, I think people were really, really feeling it. Vancouver Comic Junkie, there he is with the one here.
Right.
You know, there was only really one person out there that was pretty emphatic about it, you know, Comics with Bonics. Hey, I love Comics with Bonics. He's got a great YouTube channel. Also, go check him out, guys, if you haven't discovered Comics with
Bonics. I actually bought a DC Comics Presents 47 from him.
There you go. Comics with Bonics, you know, right when he saw that you were going to burn the copy that he ended up giving to you, he somewhere out there went a little something like this. No! That was Comics with Bonics just then. Right there. Well, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you, Comics. He-Man was a disappointment. I didn't watch the show. Let me know in the chat if you guys think that.
Yeah, I haven't watched it either. I've seen a lot of comments on, but I definitely don't always agree with everything I see on Instagram. Like I and maybe people will disagree with me now, but I really like the Black Widow movie. I mean, I thought it was a lot of fun. It was a fun action movie. I mean, I know a lot of people didn't like the gender swap, like they just kind of because they were expecting something different with that character, Taskmaster. But I mean, I thought it was a fun action movie. It reminded you what real special effects look like. You know, like we've been getting like TV show special effects, even with the MCU stuff, like the Disney Plus, it's still TV show special effects. And these were a lot higher level. The only thing I didn't like about it was the thing I've always really liked about Black Widow and Hawkeye in the MCU is that they're like normal people in the realm of like God type characters and they play their role that way. And they treated her much more like Captain America in this movie, like the damage she was taking. And so that was my only real gripe with it.
I am totally aligned with you on your feelings with the movie. I enjoyed it overall, but like in the theater while I was watching it, even though I was enjoying it, there were so many times I was like, guys,
like she fell off that building.
Shrapnel alone is gonna kill her. Like, you just, there's so much glass being shattered. Like, how is this possible? And yeah, I think that they, I don't know. They're kind of in this like weird power creep situation, right? Where they have to like every movie has.
Yeah,
to
I mean, it's tough. Yeah, when you have people that aren't normal people having to compete with people who have superpowers, you know, it is very difficult to do that. But they've really thread that needle really well up to this point.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, spec, collect, forget. We're going on to the next round here. We got some interesting ones on this one. I'm very curious to hear what you have to say. Spec, collect, forget. We have some team books here. We got Marvel Feature 1, first appearance of the Defenders team. I think that there's someone out in the chat right there, namely Dan De La Torre, that's going to be upset if you pick wrong. We got Marvel Premiere 28, first appearance of the Legion of Monsters, a team book that has gotten extremely hot recently. And we have Uncanny X-Men 121, first full appearance of Alpha Flight. So we got some kind of Bronze Age team appearance books here. Spec, collect, forget. How are you feeling? Dan just wants you to know to be very careful here.
Yeah, I mean, this is, I would say, this is the first one that I, like, immediately, I don't know where I'm going with this one. Because all of these books have definite futures, or not definite, but almost definite futures in you know, the universe of Marvel. And because they've really been talking about Alpha Flight, and we know they're getting into this like this horror monster genre. And like, yeah. I talk about this on my channel with like how hot pre-code horror books are now. Like, I think they're gonna, I mean, that's part of that is like horror is just getting really popular in general. And so they're definitely gonna play on that. And then the Defenders is just, you feel like it's a group that they're going to continue to try to leverage, you know, they're going to try to take advantage of that. So,
well, it's like, you look at the characters that are on the table, you know, two of them are actually in the MCU, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, yeah, this is one of those that I'm going to say, all right, spec, I am going to go with the monster, the Marvel Premiere 28. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Then, oh God, because I don't want to burn another X-Men book.
You got to do what you got to do.
I think I'm going to collect. I feel like Dan is gonna, he's gonna downvote me. I'm gonna collect X-Men 121 and I'm gonna burn the Defenders.
Burning the Defenders. Oh, buddy. All right. Well, we got Uncanny X-Men 121 Alpha Flight. We're collecting that book. We're showing some love for X-Men here. We're specking on Marvel Premiere 28, and we are burning Marvel Feature 1. Everybody in the chat, you know what to do. One's in the chat if you agree here. Two's in the chat if you disagree. But man, Dan was sitting in the audience, you know, he was watching, you know, his favorite book out there, and Ryan just came out of nowhere and he didn't care. He just came out of nowhere and he just pushed that book off this giant ladder like this.
One is fine. Another a back line. Matt Hardy and Bubba Ray Dudley on top of that big ladder. It's and right. Oh, no. And Bubba Ray and Jeff New fall on tables.
Oh, God. Man. I loved wrestling back when I was in high school. We would get the pay per views and stuff.
It was great.
That's so good.
Desire Man, good to see you in chat, man. All right, let's check in with the votes here. We got Carnival with the one here, Comics with Bonus with one. We're friends again. Attaboy. Brian with the one here, Lee with the one, Trilogy with the one, Ian with the one, Empire 2, St. Louis 2, Dare with the, and just like that, unfriend Ryan. We got Nowhere with the two here. We got St. Louis with the one. We got Miguel with the two. Mark with the two. Desire with the one. Mark with the two. We got, you know, a mix and match of everything. I feel like
I still feel like there are a few more ones.
I think so too. I think you're right. I'd say it was favorable to what you were thinking.
there's a three out there.
But it definitely feels like, yeah, it definitely feels like we have some Defenders fans in the chat, you know, for sure. But hey, it's okay. It's okay. These are your picks, man. These are your picks. All right. Well, going on to the next one here, we got some other nice, interesting books that I am very, very curious to hear what you have to say. Spec, collect, forget. We got Avengers 48, Special Marvel Edition 15, and Fantastic Four 13. So we got books that are pretty hot. Everything's got a show coming up, a property. Everyone's coming up you know, in some kind of way. We got Avengers 48, of course, first appearance of Black Knight. We got Special Marvel Edition, first appearance of Shang-Chi. And we got Fantastic Four 13, first appearance of Watu, the Watcher. We were talking about the Watcher early on in the show. So how are you feeling here, Ryan? Spec Collector.
Well, so anybody that watches my channel might know how many copies of Special Marvel Edition 15 I have. I have 12 copies of that book. And so that is definitely my spec book. There's no question for me on that one.
All right, so put it on the spec right away off the
bat. Yep. All right. There's no question for me on that one. Okay. Now. Oh, it's
there we go. Yeah. Yep. Send it back. Specking on right. Shang-Chi here.
All right. And because I mean, just with that, for one, I think that movie looks like it's going to be awesome. And yeah. I bought an SME 15 from Bonix too.
Oh, nice. Man, I buy some books from Bonix or something. He's got some good ones out there.
Because one, I think that movie's going to be awesome. It looks like a ton of fun. And I think street level characters are really a big thing that they're going to be pushing moving forward. And so anything that's going to be, you know, that Earth realm street level type character, I think is going to be big moving forward. So now the tough part is these next two, because Avengers 48 is a massive book now. I mean, that book, like I think in a 9-0 is like $3,000, you know, and so it's hard. It's going to be hard to throw that one away, but you're competing with Fantastic Four 13. You know, you've got early Silver Age with a pretty major character and just an always in demand book. Whereas Avengers 48, it is not like the way I look at these, that book was pretty worthless before, yeah. You know, it's like, if I didn't have it, if I didn't have that as the spec, I'm not collecting that book. So right. Collecting is going Fantastic Four 13, and I have got to get rid of Avengers 48.
All right. Well, the votes are in. We are forgetting Avengers 48. We are collecting Fantastic Four 13, and we are specking on Special Marvel Edition. You guys know what to do in the chat here. One's in the chat if you agree with Ryan's picks. Two's in the chat if you disagree. Yeah, very surprising. I mean, this one's a tough one. I mean, all of these books have more room to grow, just because we can assume that all of these books are going to have some relevance to characters coming in the MCU. But, you know, I can't argue with your logic here. The Fantastic Four book, obviously, you know, the most prestigious pre-MCU, you know, the one that's the oldest book.
I like the early Silver Age stuff, you know, and I realized, yeah, the Watcher isn't always everybody's favorite character, but it's very early Fantastic Four and one of the keys from that early set of books.
Absolutely. All right. Checking in with chat here. We got Lito with the one, Carnival with the one, Miguel with the two, Comics with the one, Trilogy with the two, Mark with the one, Mr. Nobody with the one, Basement with the one, St. Louis with the two, Phantom with the two, Ian with the two, Desire with the two, Noah with the one, Ryan, I don't know you anymore, with the two here. All right, but this one was pretty, you know, mixed and match, I'd say, like mixed and match. You know, there were definitely some people in the chat that were like, hey, you're going to work. You know, when you were like, I'm going to burn Avengers 48, this was their reaction.
Are you serious?
Well, I mean, the reason I was thinking about that Avengers 48 is because I've got a friend on Instagram that has a 9-0 of that book, and I was telling him to sell it. So that's why. I was like, I would take advantage of these prices right now. So
let me just say this. As someone who is trying to put the Avengers Grail Run together, that is one book that I still need and is going to be probably the last one that I ever end up buying for myself. I can tell you that much.
You might want to wait till the lull, you know.
I'm just going to wait till, kind of to your point, I never had an affinity towards the Black Knight character. I'm happy to be converted into a big fan, you know, if he does well in the MCU, but you know, I'm not sweating it.
If it's the book
it takes me forever to get.
It could turn out to be something like, you know, like I think a lot of people maybe think that that Tales to Astonish 13, the first Groot, was always an expensive book, but it wasn't. Like, you know, it was a nothing book until they made him popular in the MCU. Right. Like I remember looking at, I had one of my older Overstreets, and if you look at the older Overstreets, they don't even separate that book out. It's like you have issues like 9-14 or something. And, you know, yeah, and it's like, they don't even call it out as a first appearance. It's not true anymore because that book is worth a fortune now. But so it is possible that those could retain, but it's the thing that always worries me with books like that is that once they're done, if nobody cared about that character before, are they going to continue to care about that character in a long, you know, in the long term?
Yeah, very true. I mean, you know, a book is only as valuable as it is desired in pop culture. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if the brand affinity doesn't sustain, then who knows what the value will be.
And I've seen, I do have some of my SME 15s listed, but I have not, I'm still kind of, I have high hopes for that character. So somebody was asking about that.
I think we're only scratching the surface of what they can do with him. All right. Spec, collect, forget. Next round here. We got some big ones here. We got some, this, you know, I don't know if it's been easy or hard, but I feel like we got some big books on this slide here, if I remember correctly. Spec, collect, forget. We got ASM 129, Tomb of Dracula number 10, and Werewolf by Night number 32. We got some big Bronze Age first appearances here. Of course, ASM 129, first appearance of the Punisher. Tomb of Dracula 10, first appearance of Blade. Werewolf by Night, first appearance of Moon Knight here. Big characters, you know, two of them have definitely Disney Plus shows coming out in the near future. One of them, maybe an all-time classic here. Spec, collect, forget. Yeah, what do you think?
Yeah, so for me, the collect is no question because one of these books is on my 50 list, and that's mm-hmm. Amazing Spider-Man 129.
Okay,
so
okay.
That is definitely my collect book. I think it is. It's one of the best Bronze Age books in existence. You know, it's like that book, Giant Size X-Men, you know, and those are probably my top two. Then you start getting into some others like Marvel Spotlight and, you know, number five and maybe X-Men 94, that kind of thing. But I love that book. And it's that yellow cover with the red text. Then for the spec, I've got to go Werewolf by Night 32. That book is just, it is a monster. It is the book that I regret. I had a 9.2 that I regret selling more than just about any book. So that one is the spec because that show is coming. You know, I think they might even be done filming. They're working on it. We know it's coming. Whereas Tomb of Dracula, the surprising thing with that is that when Marvel did their little like sizzle reel, you know, where they were showing us all the stuff that's coming out, Blade wasn't on there, you know? And so it makes you a little nervous with what the plans are with that character. I know they've shown the guy that they've hired, but it makes you a little nervous about when are we going to see that? That one's a lot less certain. And so I like certainty when I'm going with spec type books, and we know Werewolf by Night, you know, we know Moon Knight's coming. And so that's the one.
Wow. Okay. Well, everybody in the chat, you know what to do. Ones or twos, if you agree with Ryan here. But you know, you were, you know, pretty sure about your picks here. You know, definitely not feeling the Tomb of Dracula 10. Taking a dump on it, a little something like.
Biff getting shit on him in all those movies is one of the best recurring themes in a movie of all time. I love that.
Yeah, so good. Well, Tomb of Dracula, getting manure all over it with your picks here. But I think everybody, you know, kind of agrees with you as I look over at the chat here. We got ones here. We got more ones. Lots of ones. Only one 1.5. I see 1.2 in there. But hey, overall, I mean, this is like 99% ones. So definitely feeling your picks here. No love for Blade. I mean, I'm not going to say that I would have picked Tomb of Dracula myself. But hey, ASM 129, Punisher, you know, are we going to get more Punisher? I don't know.
I mean, there are rumors that we're getting Bernthal back. So we'll see. Yeah.
I just got to shout out Carnival here. That's why I was been waiting all week for these. Yeah, absolutely. I've absolutely been waiting all week for these ones. I got a gang of you know, clips that I'm like, all right, that one's going to be a good one eventually.
I can see why it takes you longer to prep for these. I mean, you got to put those little clips together.
Yeah, I got to put the clips together, man. Jeez, you know, just just, you know, I don't know. It's so fun. It's so fun to do it. All right. Spec, collect, forget. We're going on slide number 9 here. Now, we've been talking a lot of Marvel overall, you know, but I know you to be a big DC fan. So I had to also put in some DC love here. Also, I know you to be a big Golden Age collector as well. So I also had to make this Golden Age. Now, it's a little hard to find perfect Golden Age comparisons.
It's tough to spec on Golden Age.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But I think I did pretty well. So spec, collect, forget here. We have first cover appearances of some great Batman villains here. All right. First cover appearance of great Batman villains. Of course, I didn't change the titles, but we don't need the titles because you will explain to the people before. We have Detective Comics number 67. This is the first cover appearance of the Penguin. We have Detective Comics number 68. This is the first cover appearance of Two-Face, also the second appearance of Two-Face. And then we have Detective Comics number 122. This is the first cover appearance of Catwoman. So we got some Batman, Golden Age, Rogue Gallery, cover appearance love. Spec, collect, forget. How are you doing?
I know exactly what I'm doing with this.
Okay.
With this one. So the collect 100% is the Catwoman. It's because that I love that book, and that, I mean, that's why the book that's back there in the middle is her first cover appearance in the Batman run. And right. So that's why I have that book. I love that book. And I would really want to get this one. Unfortunately, there was a Promise Collection pedigree copy that sold recently for like 28,000 or something. And so it's caused all those books up. So it's made it. So it's very hard for me to stomach purchasing that book, but I'm always watching. Whenever I see one come up for sale, I'm watching it to see if I can get it. Mm-hmm. Then the spec is going to be Tech 67, because we've got Penguin in the next Batman movie.
Is this true?
You know, I think it's like I said, it's tough to spec on Golden Age, but if there's anyone in there that you can spec on, it's that, because we've got him coming up. And then the forget is number 68. Now, I mean, it's also, I think it's kind of he's off in the distance. You know, it is his first cover, but it's not a great first cover appearance.
Second appearance too. It is his second appearance. Well, one's in the chat if you agree here, two's in the chat if you disagree. Are any of these books here on your list here? I actually do.
I don't own, I've never owned any of those, but if I got I'm blanking on the number. Is it 128? Is that what that tech is?
Which one?
The Catwoman.
22.
122. If I got 122, it would 100% be on my list. I would be cutting something else for it. There's no way I would get rid of that. Or it's one of those books that the only way I'm getting rid of it is if I get a better copy of it. Like that's how I would end up getting rid of that book. But
it's definitely a beautiful book. It is it's a great cover, a classic.
I love Robin getting his
slapped around here. It was a different time, the 1940s.
And it's not campy. That's the problem with the Penguin cover. You know, he's riding an ostrich, you know, I don't like the campy covers. Like that's the one thing. And there are a lot of them when you're talking Golden Age Batman and Superman. So it's tough to kind of weave through those to find the really like the great covers.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, I think, you know, the fans here, people in the chat agree with you here. Let's see. Basement Brothers Collectibles with the one, Carl with the one, Trilogy one, 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 lots more ones here. One on covers by themselves, one with Danley De La Torre here. So one's overall, not two in sight. Everyone is agreeing with you. And, you know, hey, we got to live vicariously through this game right now, because I know that I'm probably never going to get my hands on any of those books. Knowing what the prices are, it is absolutely insane. Well, spec, collect, forget. We got two more rounds here. We've done great so far. You know, Ryan, you've been a trooper. You've been hanging in there. A lot of people really, really feeling your picks. But we're not out of the woods yet. You know, we still have some tough choices coming up. And this one, I think, is a really interesting one. You know, hard for me to say where you're going to go. But I tried to be thematic here. You know, we have some fours, a series of fours here. Spec, collect, forget. We have, and of course, I've ruined the thing, Fantastic Four number 4. Of course, that is the first Silver Age appearance of the Submariner. We have X-Men number 4. That is the first appearance of Scarlet Witch and Quicksilver. And we have Journey into Mystery 84, which is the first appearance of Jane Foster and the second appearance of Thor. So some Silver Age classic books here, all kind of within the same kind of financial range, incidentally, but all have this thematic tie-in of four. I thought I was clever for grouping them.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Spec, collect, forget. Let me know what you think here in the chat as well, guys. And so, Ryan, what do you feel?
This one, you know, is for me is actually also pretty easy, and it's because two of those books are on my 50 list. X-Men number four and Fantastic Four number four, both on my list. Journey into Mystery 84. While it is a great book, is not. So that one, 84, that's the forget.
Burning Jane Foster.
Yep. It's general. It's surprising. Like, it's a book that you think would be worth more than it is, you know, like it's her first appearance and second appearance of Thor. And it's just, that book doesn't get any love out there.
Right.
Now for spec and collect, I think for collect, I have to go with X-Men number four because it is one of my favorite covers. I love the sunburst covers. I think they just look incredible. And so it's one of my favorite covers. And so that's the one for me that I'm going to collect. And then spec is Fantastic Four number four, based on this news that we have Submariner, potentially the villain. I don't know how much truth there is to him being the villain in the Black Panther movie, but it's caused that book to, which was already a very expensive book, to move a lot. And if he actually does show up, if it's true, then I think my book is like maybe a 0.5 or a 1. I'm going to wish I would have upgraded it because I'm never going to be able to after that.
Absolutely. I mean, that is definitely a book that has absolutely skyrocketed.
I get a kick out of Human Torch, because, you know, he's yelling at him to stop Submariner from getting to the water, and he's already in the water. Like, I don't know what he's talking about. He's already made it. They're screwed.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Mr. Fantastic, just, you know, stretch and reach him. Do something. All right. Well, we got to check in with the audience here. We got to check in with the chat. Let's see, one's in the chat if you agree here, two's in the chat if you disagree. I think people are feeling this, though. We see one here with St. Louis, one with Basement, one with Miguel, one with Ian, one with Dan, one with Basement Brothers Collectibles, another one. Trilogy with the one here. Everybody is feeling the one overall. And look, like, you know, sometimes you just got to sacrifice a book. You know, you just have to say one of them's going to get burned. You know, it's just in order to save your collection, you just gotta go head first into one of them, a little something like,
I'm back!
God. I hope Vancouver's still in here. I was about to comment recently.
I was gonna say, if Vancouver is not in the chat right now, we'd be severely disappointed.
I think he left. Oh god, like
man, I made a special one for him.
I was laughing through. I don't know if my mic comes through or not, but I was laughing during that.
Yeah. All right. Well, burning Journey into Mystery 84, no big deal. Blowing it up like Independence Day. Alien spaceship. All right, we have our final round here. Spec, collect, forget. You know, we had to pull out some of the big grails, some hot books here. I've had a couple of these in previous iterations of this game, but I've reshuffled the lineup, so maybe we can get a fresh take in this one. But all right. Spec, collect, forget. We have some of the all-time holy grails. Some of the all-time holy grails here. We have, of course, I forgot to change all the titles in the last three slides, so ignore it, guys. Okay, I was spending a lot of time making these videos.
The videos are worth it. Yeah,
blowing up. All right, give me a break. All right, everyone's already calling me out. Let me just get rid of this. All right, okay. All right, click to add text. All right, here we go. Incredible Hulk number one, Fantastic Four number one, and X-Men number one. Holy grails from the Silver Age, one of the original superheroes of all time, Marvel's first family, and everybody's favorite superheroes, the X-Men.
I sadly don't own any of these. And if people have seen my videos where I talk about like the books I buy, I tend to I've tended to steer clear of them because I can't get deals on these books because they're always so expensive and everybody wants them. And yeah. So I'm a person that's always trying to get a deal on a book. And so that makes, you know, books like this very difficult to purchase. But I think, I mean, it hurts me to do it because I think it is an incredible cover, an incredible book, but Incredible Hulk is being forgot. I'm putting that one with the forget. And the collect, I'm going with X-Men number one. Mm. Because I think I don't know why. I could flip a coin with Fantastic Four number one and X-Men number one on what I would do with it, because I would love to have both of those. Yes, Hulk is too strong to burn.
He's the immortal Hulk now. He can't actually.
But then I'm going to spec on Fantastic Four because the reason I'll say that is that X-Men are a very popular title in general across the board. You know, they've had very popular storylines even recently that people are really into. So I think they are a very good long-term just, you know, book to hold. And it's a great cover. And you've got First Magneto, one of the best villains of all time. Fantastic Four, while it is an awesome book, the Fantastic Four, for whatever reason, that run of books, they don't ever seem to perform as well as like Spider-Man and X-Men books. And so I think, you know, with Fantastic Four coming into the MCU, that's going to be the chance for this book to really pop. And I think that's when you can spec on it.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, not to go on a little soapbox here, but I just had to throw this out because we're having this conversation. Look, I think Fantastic Four is great. I everything, you know, that I know of them, it seemed pretty cool. But, you know, everybody always says that Fantastic Four is amazing. You know, everyone always talks about that. And everyone's like, oh, you got to check out these Fantastic Four books. But, like, I don't know. Like,
every I never time hear I've anybody seen a movie, say that.
Well, I feel like everybody says Fantastic Four is awesome. But it's like every time we've gotten the movie, every time I've watched a cartoon done of them, every time I read, like, their new comic books and things like that, I don't know. I don't know.
I think people want them to be good because they, you know, it's like, it's Marvel's first family, you know, it's like, it's the thing that saved Marvel. So people really, they want to love it, but it just, a lot of times they don't, you know, it just, in terms of prices, like they don't get the same attention as some of these other runs. Like, I mean, to me, it's like top tier is Spider-Man, then X-Men, then Fantastic Four, then probably Iron, like maybe, I don't know. It's tough there. Maybe Journey into Mystery and Tales of Suspense are kind of flipping a coin, but yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, we got to check in with the chat really quick here. One's in the chat, two's in the chat. Comments with Vonix. He's got the lots of ones here. Carnival here. One, but there are no wrong answers. I agree. Michael with the one. St. Louis with the one. Brothers, Basement Brothers with the one here. Lee with the two, but it's a coin toss. One, not bad. Went 10 out of 11. And we have some more ones with Mark here and Ian here. So overall, I think everybody mostly agrees with you. I mean, I can't deny, like, if, you know, you got to think of it like this, right? If all of a sudden someone ran up to you in the street holding all three of these books and was like, you can grab one. Like, just, I think instinctually, most people would grab X-Men. It just feels like that's the book that everybody is in love with. Or that's the team that's, you know, everybody just wants X-Men.
Yeah. And that's the same thing that, that Newbie has said on his Grail versus Grail. It's like, treat it like somebody's throwing two books at you, you know, like which one, you know, which one do you save? You know, which one do you
like
grab?
You go home today with this book in your hands, which one is it going to be, you know? And I feel like, X-Men is just that team, you know? So anyways, that is all. Those were 10 rounds, Ryan. You made it through spec, collect, forget. Thank you so much for playing. Thank you for being a sport. I think you did pretty well. I think everybody in the chat mostly agreed with your picks here. And thank you so much for playing.